We thank the Lord for giving you the eagerness to hear and learn the Bible lessons daily. These programs are sent every day to help those who do not get the time to read the Bible systematically, as well as those who have already read the Bible several times yet desire to get reminded about the teachings of the Bible in a clear and deep way in English and Tamil languages. These programs are being sent in both audio and script formats every day to help us grow in the knowledge of God. Kindly continue to listen, read, and be benefited by these lessons daily. However, these programs should in no way be used to replace the Bible. These are being sent mainly to encourage and motivate you to read and to study your own Bibles regularly. God bless you all.
Learn the Bible series, program number 110, Bible Depths Notes, Part 8, Portion 4, pages 1-2, the book of 1 Thessalonians. Introduction, Acts 17:1-15. In the course of his second missionary journey, Paul, along with Silas, reached a city called Thessalonica. He came to know that there was a Jewish synagogue in that city, and so he preached the gospel there on three consecutive Sabbath days. What was the result? A small number of Jews accepted what Paul preached. Along with them, a large number of Greeks and women from respectable backgrounds also accepted Paul's teachings. But the non-believing Jews who rejected Paul's preaching gathered in large numbers and assaulted the house of one Jason, who had sheltered both Paul and Silas in his house. Fearing more problems, the brothers in Thessalonica sent away Paul and Silas that same night to the neighboring city of Berea. Paul preached also in the synagogue of Berea. The people in Berea were more noble than the ones in Thessalonica because they searched the scriptures every day and compared them with what Paul told them. Therefore, many Jews in Berea, along with a large number of respectable Greek men and women, accepted Paul's words. But when the unbelieving Jews in Thessalonica came to know about Paul's ministry in Berea, they also went to Berea and created trouble there. So the brothers in Berea escorted Paul safely up to Athens and left him there. Meanwhile, a church got established in Thessalonica through the three Sabbath days ministry of Paul. And it is to that infant church that Paul is writing this letter. Paul is giving many guidances to the Thessalonians in this letter. We shall study a few of them. 1 Thessalonians 2:10 and 11. Paul is advising the believers in the Thessalonian church to walk worthy of God, who had graciously called them into his kingdom and glory. What does he mean by that? A believer should always conduct himself in such a way that he does not bring a bad name to God. 1 Thessalonians 4:3-8, the people in Thessalonica never gave importance to marriage relationships. They would seek a wife only to get some children for them and would quench their sexual urges by going to the prostitutes liberally. Believers in the Thessalonian church also were no exception to that type of living. So Paul writes to them that only the Gentiles would live like that, but a child of God should not do such things. He should keep his body holy by abstaining from that uncleanness. 1 Thessalonians 4:12, Paul says that a believer should not be a chatterbox, but be a quiet person. He should not poke his nose unnecessarily into other people's activities, but only mind his business. We shall continue this lesson in our next program. God bless you all.